ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम फर्स्ट कैंटो फर्स्ट चैप्टर टेक्स्ट नंबर 2। धर्म प्रोजित कैतवोत्र परमो निर्मत्सराणां सतां वेद्यं वास्तवमत्र वस्तु शिवदम् तापत्रयोन्मूलनम् श्रीमद्भागवते महामुनिकृते किं वा परैरीश्वरः सद्यो हृद्यवरुध्यते अत्र कृतिभिः शुश्रूषुभिस्तत्क्षणात्। Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Translation: completely rejecting all religious activities which are materially motivated, this Bhagavata Purana propounds the highest truth which is understandable by those devotees who are fully pure in heart. The highest truth is reality distinguished from illusion for the welfare of all. Such truth uproots the threefold miseries. This beautiful Bhagavatam, compiled by the great sage Vyasadeva in his maturity, is sufficient in itself for God realization. What is the need of any other scripture? As soon as one attentively and submissively hears the message of Bhagavatam, by this culture of knowledge, the Supreme Lord is established within his heart. It's a very long purport, about 70 slides, so we'll proceed with the class. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
वंदेहं श्री गुरु।
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, first chapter, text number 2, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 23rd of February 1975 in Caracas, Venezuela.
Dharma prochita kaitava yatra parama nirma sarana sadang vidam vastava vastu matram vidam vastama matra vastu shivadam tapatayan nanam simada bhagavati mahamuni krite kingma pare ishara शब्दो दिदि अवरुद्धति अत्र पृथ्वी सुसुसुगे तत्परा। So dharma means generally a kind of day dharma, but actually dharma does not mean that. Faith, you may have faith and others may not have, but that is not fact. That is fact which is accepted by everyone. Either he may have faith or may not have faith. In Sanskrit language, the Vedic literature, dharma means the codes or the law given by God. So, one may have faith or one may not have faith. It doesn't matter. The codes or law given by God, that is a fact. Just like the law given by the state, one may not have faith or one may have faith, but it must be accepted. For example, just on the street, we see, keep to the right. This is the law given by the state. So, you may believe it or not believe it, you have to carry out. So, it cannot be changed in any circumstance. Therefore, dharma does not mean a faith. It is compulsory. So, the compulsory law is that God is great and we are subordinate or servant of God. You may believe or not believe, the God's law will apply upon you forcibly. exactly like the state law. You may have faith or no faith, you must accept it, otherwise it will be possibly imposed upon. So, dharma, as it is explained in English dictionary, a kind of faith, that is not proper meaning. Dharma means that you are obliged to obey the laws given by God. Just like our material condition, birth, death, old age and disease. So one may say that I do not believe in death. That is false. You may believe or not believe, you have to die. Similarly, one may believe or not believe, he has to take birth. But death means to give up this body and accept another body. That is very nicely explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Prathadehantaram prapti dhirasatanamiyati. Just like a child, he must accept the body of the boy. The boy, he must accept next the body of a youth. And the youth must accept the old man's body. This is the law of God. You must accept. And just when this body is no more practically usable, then you have to accept another body and begin a new life. This is the law of nature or the law of God. Law of nature is dull, material. Nature cannot work automatically without the incentive or manipulation of God behind nature. Foolish people think that nature is working automatically. That is their ignorance. Nature is working under the direction of the Supreme Lord. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Maya dhakshena prakriti svyati sacharacharam hetu nanena kaunteya jagadvi parivartate. Lord says that under my superintendence, the material nature is working and therefore so many wonderful changes are going on. So, nature is working under the order of the Supreme Lord and we are under the stringent laws of nature. Therefore, we are obliged to carry out the natural sequences, just like I already explained, from childhood to boyhood, boyhood to youthhood, youthhood to old age. These are natural laws, and after mature old age, you have to change this body and accept another body. So if we say that I have no faith in the orders of the material nature, I can avoid it, that is not possible. So therefore this dharma means you may have faith or may not have faith, you have to abide by the laws of nature. People therefore say, as sure as death, I may think or you may think that don't care for faith, there will be no death, but it will happen. Therefore the conclusion is that you cannot manufacture any laws of religion. Man-made religion has no value. So man-made religion, there are so many religious systems. Hindu religion, Christian religion, Mahayana religion, or this religion, that religion. That is a kind of faith. But religion means the order of the laws given by God. Therefore, here it is said, dharma prochita koita bhaktra. Koita means cheating type of religious system. Real religion means God is there, I am there. God is great, I am subordinate, I must abide by the laws of God. That is, at the present moment, under the spell of illusion in this material condition, we have forgotten our real religion. Real religion means to revive our consciousness. We say Krishna consciousness or God consciousness, by which we agree to abide by the laws of God. So, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, at the end, Sarva dharman paritajya mam ekam saranam vraja. He says that you have manufactured so many religious systems, so you give up all this. You simply surrender unto me. Therefore, real conclusion is, real religion means to surrender unto God. It is explained in another place of Srimadha Bhagavatam. Savai kunsana paro dharma jato bhakti rato khale ahoituki apratihata jenatma sam prasid. That is first class religion. What is that? Savai kunsana paro. First class religion, jato bhakti rato khale, which teaches us how to surrender to God and love. Ahoituki apratihata jenatma sam prasidati. Ahituki means without any motive. Apratihata, without any checking. Jinatma sam prasidati. If you come to that platform religion, then you become fully satisfied. Generally, there are four principles in the human society, namely dharma, artha, kama, and moksha. Means, first of all become religious, then solve your economic problem, and then satisfy your senses, and then become one with God. Those who are following the Vedic principles, they think like that. Not only they, others also, the so-called religious system, they also think like that. Just like the Christians, they go to church, God give us our daily bread. So this bread supplying business is like that, God simply supplies bread and we eat and we enjoy. Similarly, the Hindu system also there is, God give me some money, I am very poor, I am suffering from disease, please cure it. And so, everywhere you will find some motive in religion. So, religion does not mean to solve the economic problem. Therefore, at the present moment, they are becoming godless because now people are advanced in education and knowledge. They think that if I have to ask bread from God, so why shall I go to God? Let me earn money very nicely and I can purchase bread. Why shall I go to church? On account of this motivated religion, the communists are taking advantage and they're preaching godlessness. In communist country, the innocent village people, they go to church and ask for bread. And when they come out of the church, the communist leader asks them, have you got bread? So they say, now ask bread from us. So they ask bread, oh communist leader, give me bread. So they supply immense quantity of bread, take as much as you like. So then they ask, who has supplied bread? They say, the communist leader. In this way they propagate, now there is no use of going to the church or asking bread from God. And they also practically see that we in the church, we asked for bread, there was no supply of bread. And as soon as they bread from the communist leader, there are so many bread. But the innocent people, they do not know that these communist leader has supplied bread not from his father's stock, it is from the stock of God. So they are innocent people, they do not know. Actually, bread is supplied by God because the ingredients of bread, namely the food grains, the wheat or the pulses, that is not made by communist leader, that is made by God. Therefore, the conclusion is that if we approach God for some material benefit, we may be cheated at some time. Therefore, it is said, dharma prochita atra koitava. This kind of motivated religious system is completely thrown away from this Śrīmad-bhāgavatam. Intelligent person should know that God is supplying food to so many living entities, why He shall not supply me? There are 8,400,000 forms of living entities. Out of that, only 400,000 forms are human body. So, 8 million means there are fishes, there are trees, there are plants, there are insects, there are birds, beasts, and in this way, 8 million. They are getting all their foodstuff supplied by God. This morning, we are walking on the in the park. We saw so many fruits have thrown on the street. That means the birds have eaten them, and they have thrown so many. So God supplies immense bread or eatable things without any asking. In the African jungle, there are hundreds of thousands of elephants. They eat at a time, huge quantity of food, but still they are supplied by God. Actually, even from practical point of view, I have traveled all over the world. There are immense places we can produce foodstuff for supplying food, 10 times of the whole world population. So therefore, there is no need of approaching God with a motive for material supplies and material satisfaction. In the Vedic literature, we get information. Nitya nityanam chetanas chetananam ekoj bhunam vidadati kaman. God, the description of God is given there, that He is also a living entity like us. He is also eternal like us. Nitya nityanam chetanas chetananam. But what is the difference between Him and us? That is described, ekoj bhunam vidadati kaman. That one God is supplying all the necessities of this many. So we should not approach God for economic satisfaction or for bread or for food or for anything necessary for our life. God has arranged food for everyone. The aquatics, the birds, the beasts, the trees, the elephants or the other and four-legged animals, and why not for human being? Human being also, those who are civilized, still living in the forest, they have no arrangement for economic development, or they do not know, but they have got also food. That what Shastra said, Tashaiva heta prajate tapogita nalabhati jat bhamadahu parajata tallabhati dukkha badanna tasukham kalena sarvatra gavira. One should try for developing God consciousness, not for anything else. And because happiness and distress, they come automatically. We haven't got to try for it. Happiness, everyone aspires for happiness. Nobody aspires for distress, but distress is forcibly come upon us. Similarly, the Shastra says, as distress come without any desire, similarly happiness also will come without any endeavor. So now we are in the material world. The so-called happiness and distress will come and go. But our, the human life, the endeavor should be how to find out or revive our relationship with God. That is our main. Just like seasonal changes, happiness and distress. Matras varsat kunti sitasna sikurukkada. Just like there is winter season, it is pinching cold. That will also not stay and the scorching heat, that is also not stay, it comes and goes. Therefore, so long in the material world we are, the so-called happiness and distress will come and go. Don't bother about it. You simply try for reviving your Krishna consciousness of God. So, human being has misunderstood the mode of life. They are simply busy for maintaining this body whole day and night. So, we should conclude like this, that if God can supply 8 million types of different lower animals, then why cannot God give the necessities of life to the human society? So don't execute your religious principle for some material benefit, but try to revive your relationship with God and try to love Him. That type of religious system is there in the Srimad Bhagavatam, that there is no motive but to how to love God, that is stated. This type of religion means to love God is stated here as Sivadam Tapatrayo Unmulanam. Sivadam means all elasticity and the threefold miserable condition of life is completely uprooted. On account of this material body, we have got threefold miseries within this material world. One is called Adhyatik. Adhyatik means miserable condition due to this material body and the mind. The other miserable condition is Adhibhogi, miserable condition offered by other living entities. And the third miserable condition is which is offered by the nature, just like earthquake, famine, pestilence, and so many other things on which we have no control. We have no control in any kind of miserable condition, especially the miserable condition offered by nature, we cannot avoid. So therefore, here it is said that if you take up this religious system, means how to love God, then you will be transcendental to all this miserable condition of material existence. And these information, these practices are given in the Srimad Bhagavatam, which is compiled by, not by any ordinary person, but Srimad Bhagavati Mahamuni Krite, the greatest saint, Vyasadeva, he has given that. In ordinary literature, that full of mistakes and cheating and illusion and imperfectness. Every condition soul has been young. We have got four defects. Namely, we commit mistake. We have sometimes illusion and sometimes we do not know properly anything and still I give my thesis. Perhaps it may be, well, it is not. That means cheating. One has sufficient knowledge and perhaps maybe is giving knowledge. And above all of that, we should know that our present material senses are imperfect. For example, just like we are very much proud of our eyes, we say, can you show me God? But our eyes are so long perfect as long as the light is. It is conditioned. Therefore, every sense now we are possessing, they are not perfect. So, we acquire knowledge by using our different knowledge senses. Therefore, because they are imperfect, whatever knowledge we gather by speculation, that is imperfect. So, if we take knowledge from such personalities who are liberated, then that knowledge is perfect. This is the process of acquiring knowledge in Krishna consciousness movement, that we receive knowledge from the perfect person. Now, here it is said that because it is given by the perfect person Vyasadeva, we should take knowledge from this Srimad Bhagavatam. And the proof is that we have now become godless. We have no information of God. But if you read Srimad Bhagavatam, then immediately you realize God. Just like you can see in reality that these boys, these girls who have joined this Krishna consciousness like movement, because they are reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, they are now gradually realizing what is God and what is His relationship with God. So unless we realize God and our position and we become lover of God, there is no question of peace in the mind. Therefore it is recommended here that if you want real peace in the mind, try to understand what is God, what is your relationship with God, and act accordingly. He will be immediately peaceful. As soon as you become peaceful, your life is successful. Thank you very much.
You can explain something, what the scientists are always talking about, mutation and mutation. That's right. And variation, and how one species evolves to another species.
By the mind, intelligence and ego, at the time of death, you think of what you have done all through your life. So, the mental situation at the time of death will carry you to the different form of life as your mental situation. We do not see the mind, intelligence, although we say that I have got mind, you have got mind, you have got intelligence, I have got intelligence. But we do not see it. It is a very subtle thing. But after the destruction of this gross body, the subtle body carries me to another gross body. We have got practical experience. The mind is so forceful that you are sitting here and within a second you can go to your home or homeland, which may be 10,000 miles away. The example is given just like from a garden, rose garden, the flavor is carried by the air and it is transferred to another place. So in this life, whatever mental creation we are doing or creating, that will be carried in the next life. And according to that, nature will give us a body. So if we think of dog, maybe I am transferred to the dog's body. If I think of God, then I shall transfer to a God's body. So we have scattered our love for so many things in the material world. We have to collect everything and transfer everything for loving God. That is successful. So if we think of God, then how we become purified and next we become transferred to the kingdom. And if we think of material things, then again we shall be transferred to another material body. This Krishna consciousness movement is for educating people how to think of God constantly. And if we practice like that, then after giving up this body, we are going to get a body which is exactly like God. This body is called Svachitananda. Short means Chitanga, Chit means full of knowledge, and Ananda means full of bliss. This body, this material body, is just the opposite number. It is neither eternal, neither full of knowledge, neither full of bliss. And if we develop Krishna consciousness and God consciousness, then next body we shall get a body